Legion was lonely. Edward came to see him every day, but there wasn't enough work for Trevor to do, and it depressed him terribly.
Well, I do like keeping busy whenever I can, you know.
He sighed one day.
And I do like company, especially if it's children's company. Well, you know, they're very fond of steam engines themselves, aren't they?
Cheer up,
smiled Edward.
The Fab Controller has a job for you. He sent me to tell you all about it. I'm to take you to the junction to meet Thomas today.
Oh,
exclaimed Trevor happily.
Well, I can imagine what that would involve. A harbour. The seaside. And that can only mean the chance to give children rides when the job's done. Marvellous. The chance of a lifetime.
Thomas was waiting at the junction. He was on his way to the harbour with a trainload of steel pilings. These would be built into the harbour walls to make them firm and safe.
Hello, Thomas,
said Edward.
This is Trevor, an old friend of mine. He's a traction engine.
Thomas eyed the newcomer doubtfully.
A what?
He asked.
A traction engine,
explained Trevor.
That's basically a way of saying a steam engine that can run on roads instead of rails. Could you take me to the harbour, please? I understand it from Edward that the Fat Controller has a job for me there.
Yes, of course.
Workmen coupled Trevor's truck to Thomas's train, and they set off.
Useful engines run on rails,
grumbled Thomas to himself. But luckily, Trevor didn't hear him.
I'm glad the Fat Controller needs me,
said Trevor happily.
I don't have enough to do occasionally, you know. Although having said that, I can work anywhere. In orchards, on farms, in scrapyards. Even in this case, at harbours. You'd be amazed how useful a steam engine of my sort can be.
Thomas was puzzled.
But you don't run on rails,
he objected.
Well, that's the whole point. I don't need rails just to be useful, however much you may think otherwise yourself.
Fine, Trevor.
You wait and see.
But when they reached the harbour, they found everything in confusion. Trucks had come off the rails, they blocked the line, and the stone they had held lay higgledy-piggledy.
You must get these pilings passed,
said Thomas's driver.
They're essential. If only we had a tractor to drag them round this mess. Terrence could have done it.
Just the sort of job I like,
interrupted Trevor excitedly.
Would you get me off this truck, please? I'll handle this for you. Now you'll see, Thomas. I'll soon show you what an old traction engine can do.
Quickly, they unloaded him, and he set to work at once. First, he dragged the stones clear with chains. Then, he towed into position the pilings that Thomas had brought so that they were ready for the workmen to use. Everything was shipshape before the foreman could say Fat Controller. And later, when Thomas brought Annie and Clarabelle, full of children from the villages along his branch line, Trevor gave them rides along the harbour. He had the time of his life. Thomas was most impressed.
Now I understand how useful a traction engine can be.
Said Annie.
He reminds me of Thomas,
added Clarabelle. Everyone was sorry when it was time for Trevor to go. They loaded him onto his truck once more, and Thomas pulled him to the junction.
I'll come and see you again if I can,
he promised.
If those silly trucks don't behave, we may need you again.
That would be wonderful,
said Trevor happily.
It's nice to know that happy times are here to stay.
And that night, when he fell happily asleep under the apple trees in the vicarage orchard, he dreamt of Thomas, the Fat Controller's harbour, and most of all, the fun he had had giving rides to the children.